Remember, bro, this is our time together. This video will be long, so grab a snack, grab a drink, sit down, watch, laugh, sing along, whatever. You know what I mean? Just enjoy this moment with me, bro. Let me spend some time with you, twin. You feel me? Bro, welcome back to another vlog. So today we are actually, me and my family are taking a trip. Let me show you the van that we got. See this motherfucker? But we are, that's the van. You coming? All right. Well, we're taking a trip to Texas. Me and my family. And call a little bitch ass. But we're going to Texas for a couple of days. And then, yeah. It's just nice and shit. I could use some in
flour. You feel like you get some more?
I thought it was gonna be worse than this. $57? Basically to fill it up. But it's $337.
Actually?
Yeah. It's not that bad, huh? Shit. Wait, so we're in New Mexico right now?
Yeah.
God damn. Shit. I'm not gonna lie, this shit looking kinda nice though. I'm not gonna lie to you.
They say New Mexico is just like another area.
Yeah.
Same.
I know some is from out here. This is a better view of the land that's or the. It's like a sprint. No, is it sprint van? Oh no, it's a 15, no, 12 passenger van of some sort. I don't know. Fuck, bro. I'm not gonna lie. I feel like I might be catching some shit, bro. Cause it's like hard as fuck for me to swallow, bro. Especially when I try to like gulp down or swallow some shit, bro. Nigga, right there, my throat hurts like a bitch, bro. Fuck. Hopefully, I'm not sick. But who knows? I'm not gonna lie, bro. We've been driving for like 10 hours, basically. And although the van is all nice and shit, bro, the seats are so fucking uncomfortable, bro. My whole body fucking hurts like a bitch, bro. Just from sitting on those fucking seats and shit, bro. And my back is hurting like a bitch. Oh, fuck. Fuck. And I got like four more hours to go. All right, so this is the hotel that I'm going to be staying at. Look at this shit. Let me see. Oh man, the bed feels looking kind of nice. The bathroom and shit. Hey, where the fuck is the light, nigga? What the fuck? God damn, dirty the off in this bitch. I'm trying to find the light, dog. What the fuck? Hey, this shit ghetto as hell. Yeah. Oh, dude. So I used to work for a hotel. I swear to God, bro. It was one of those Holiday Inn, the long stay term. And they used, like, at the hotel that I used to work for, they used to make us do this shit. Man, that's so nostalgic. But yeah, that's the hotel. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And then fucking Ironborn, of course. Some fucking coffee and shit. I'm not gonna lie, bro. My throat hurts like a bitch, bro. So I can't really I can't really say much right now because my throat hurts like a motherfucker, bro. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. It's been hurting ever since that we started coming on this trip, bro. I don't know what's going on, but yeah, but look, that's basically the whole spot. Oh, you know what? This bed is so anticlimactic. I thought it was be more softer, but it's not. This shit low-key lame as hell. Oh, lame as hell for real, bro. I wanted to sink in, not just bounce up, you know? I'm not gonna lie, bro. This might be like a dick move to do, but I really don't give a fuck. I think I'm gonna take this bed as opposed to that one, because if something were to happen, nigga, at least this is farther away from that shit. It's farther away from the door. So I'm gonna stay over here, and then I think my dad or not my dad, somebody else is gonna be sleeping over there, and I'm gonna be over here. But shit, I'm not gonna lie, I low key feel like a terrible guy, but I don't give a fuck, yo, you know what I'm saying? Bro, all of this shit, like how to fold this, how to do this, how to do all of this. Like, when I used to work at the hotel, they taught us how to do all this shit, bro. And I know why they put this on there, this, you know what I mean? Like, you never know what kind of job, like, what you learn from that shit. I think he fucked it up because, hold on, let me see. No, he did it good. He did it right. Because you want to, so, man, I'm not teaching niggas anything, yeah. But yeah, bro, I'm not gonna lie, bro. I'm tired of the bitch, bro. I'm about to knock the fuck out, bro. I've been sleeping this whole, like, I've been falling in and out of sleep the whole, like, I think it was like 12, 13 hour. It was basically 14 hour car ride, bro. So I'm about to knock out for right now. I'm gonna talk to y'all niggas when I wake up and later.
Next time I know, like old chicken.
Yeah. But we just stopped at this, like, let me see if I can show you. Let me flip the camera real quick. That, like, Little Panda Chinese restaurant. I'm not gonna lie, that shit was looking gas. So now we're about to go back to the church, because we're here for like a conference and shit. Well, that's one of the reasons why I'm here. And then we're gonna go do some other shit. This is my food and shit and my drink. Remember, Little Panda. So if you're ever in Abilene, Texas, try that shit. It's looking good and it's cheap. It's like 10 bucks for a plate like this and a drink. Shit, bro, like this, I'm not gonna lie to you, bro, this shit feels like a whole new world, bro. Like, this is a small ass town, bro. Look at that shit. Abilene Millwork, bro. Like, look at this shit, bro. This shit does not feel real, bro.
Oh, please.
Oh god, bro. Fuck. Bro, I'm not gonna lie, bro. I feel like a fucking tourist. Why, yeah, the fuck? I'm not from out here. But, bro, this shit is mesmerizing, to say the very least, bro. Hold on, look at this shit. Let me see. Nigga, what? These are actual train tracks, twin? Let me see. You guys ever watched that movie, Stand By Me? I was gonna make a terrible joke, but I'm not being insensitive. But look at this shit, bro. I'm not gonna lie, bro. This shit is nice as fuck, bro. I think this is the best part about traveling, bro. You get to like experience new things, see new things. Like, look at this shit, bro. What? And this shit just like in the public, bro. You know what I'm saying? Abilene Millwork. And it's just right there, smack dab in the middle. Got some trash cans and shit. Like, bro, this compared to a big city is like something. It's like something I've never experienced or seen before, bro. You know? I don't know. Something about it just seems refreshing. Something about it seems rewarding, you know? To say the very least. Shit. Yeah, bro. Beautiful. If I could give if I can give all my young niggas some advice, if I can give all my young niggas some advice, it would be this, bro. Is if you have the means to travel, even if you don't have the means, bro, I advise anybody to at least try and step out of their circle and go experience a little bit of the world, bro. Just because you never know what you're gonna get to see. You're never gonna know who you might meet. You're never gonna know like what's really out there in the world if you don't go out and try to experience it as much as you can. You know what I'm saying? So if I could give any of my niggas a piece of advice, it's to try. Nigga, my hands is tired than a bitch, bro. Fuck. Try and travel as much as you can, bro. You feel me? But look at this beautiful. Look at this shit, bro. Look at that sunset, boy. Fuck. It's nice as hell. Look at this shit, bro. My nigga John right there. His black dude right there. He's the one that owns this. They just recently opened this shit, bro. Shit nice as fuck. So we made a stop to Walmart of all places, picking up some medicine for my throat and shit. You know what I mean? But I'm not gonna lie, this Walmart is pretty nice. They don't have the you see the shorts that bitch ass nigga's wearing? I wanted them bitches, but they don't have them. So I think I'm gonna just settle for this and some. You couldn't find it, bro? Go ask her. She'll tell you. But hopefully this shit helps my my throat. And tomorrow I don't feel terrible and shit. Make my sister a bitch ass nigga. You ever seen that? You ever seen that meme? Huh?
You what he said?
I said make my shit straight, bitch ass nigga.
I'm not even doing the hairline again. He got something you can see for me.
Bro, this is gonna be, I'm gonna call it a night here. I'm gonna get some rest and shit. So I'm gonna talk to y'all niggas tomorrow. Shit, bro, good morning with y'all niggas, bro. Bro, I'm not gonna lie, bro. Remember I was taking shots of the, I gotta pee like a bitch. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. I think one of my weird, like, I don't know if it's a kink, something that I love. I love peeing, bro. Like, it sounds weird as fuck, but I love peeing, bro. Like, fuck. It's almost equivalent to finishing. If you catch my drift, you feel me? But like I was saying, bro, last night, remember how I was taking shots of the fucking medicine, bro? Nigga, my fucking throat, nigga, this shit hurts like a bitch, bro. Like even when I try to swallow, I have to swallow slowly, bro. Cause it has to go past this shit and then it goes back, it goes down. But it's almost hard for me to swallow shit, bro. You feel me? Fuck, this shit hurts like a motherfucker, bro. God damn, bro. But fuck, I just got up literally 5 minutes ago, bro. So I might get ready, brush my teeth, wash my face. You know what I mean? Look at the cup. You know what I'm saying? get ready. Then I'm gonna go to the church. Then I'm gonna go do some other shit. But yeah, bro. Good morning to y'all niggas. Bro, look at this. Hold on. Oh my god, nigga, look at all that steam that's coming off that motherfucker. Nigga, I'm gonna tear this shit up, boy. Hold on, I'm gonna do a little mukbang for y'all niggas. Hold on. Bro, look at that shit, bro. Oh, fuck. Hold on, let me find a place to set up the camera, and then I'm gonna do the video for y'all niggas. Hold on. I'm not gonna lie to you, bro. This shit makes it hard, cause like I said, I can't. It's really hard for me to swallow shit. So I'm gonna see how this goes, bro. I'm not gonna lie. The rice. Fuck. Hold on, let me try the chicken. Hold on. Because it's supposed to be orange chicken. It's mediocre at best. The thing is, I like flavor, you know what I mean? Fuck. It feels like there's something right here that's like congesting the food from being digested and going down. It's like cotton. Or like an air filter. You know, like an air filter? You know how like hard things go through? I mean, hard thing doesn't go through, but liquid does. That's how it feels like in my throat. Cause like, it feels congested to the motherfucker right here. But as soon as I digest a liquid, it just goes right through that motherfucker. But anything hard, it has to process it first. You know what I'm saying? But like I was saying, bro, the food is like the rice, it lacks flavor. You feel me? Like, it's like, I don't know, bro. I'm not saying it's bad. I'm just saying, hold on. I think this is the sauce that they use to like put on the chicken and shit. You know what I hate? Hold on. All right, bro. You know, my biggest pet peeve is when somebody's eating and they get to smacking. Bro, I hate that shit with a fucking burning passion, bro. I hate smackers, bro. You know what I mean? Like when somebody's eating and shit and they get to smacking all loud and shit, bro. It's like, bro, what the fuck are you, bro? Are you even human? Like, how the fuck do you not know how to eat, bro? You know what I mean? Like, I hate fucking smackers, bro. So, and I'm saying all this, even though I realize like some people, it just like they're born with it. You know what I mean? Some people are just like, they're just like that. You know, but me, even when I eat, I intentionally try. Oh shit! I just spit like a motherfucker. I intentionally try not to like smack. Like I try to like catch myself before I smack and shit, because I know that shit is annoying, bro. And fuck. But yeah, I fucking hate smackers, bro. I hate it. I hate them, bro. And when my siblings get to smacking, bro, nah, bro. I, that shit pisses me the fuck off, bro. Like, what? Like, ugh. When I was about, how old was I at the time? I was about, like, I think I was 12 at the time. It was back in Georgia. It was 10 or 12. I went to this, like, black American church. Like, it was full of black people. And you know how older women are, bro. They're wise and shit, and they want the best for you. So I remember, I think I told you this story before. I remember one time, bro, I'm not gonna lie, bro. This is a side note. Bro, at this church, there was this one girl. I was in love with her, bro. She was the most beautiful girl that I have ever seen in my life, bro. Even to this day, I still think about her, bro. Like, she was this, like, light-skinned little joint. Like, she was so bad, too. I was infatuated with this girl, bro. Like, I wanted to... Oh, my God, bro. She had a sister, too, and her sister was so fine, bro. But this girl, she was either, because I can't really remember that well, but I remember she had a high skin complexion. So she was either white or she was light skin. Bro, but she was so bad. But I remember one time we would go on like Saturdays, we would go and volunteer and shit, bro. And I'm not going to lie. Like, we'll go into a room and we'll be folding clothes or we would be putting clothes in bags and shit. And I remember it was just me and her one time and was talking and shit, bro. I feel like that's at that moment, that's when I fell in love with her, bro. She was just so gorgeous to me, bro. Like, and she would just smile, giggle, you know what I mean? And like, but back to the story I was telling you before. So I remember this one time, I was about 10 or 12 years old at the time, right? these ladies, these older black ladies, they pulled me to the side. They was like, you know what, young man? Like, we're gonna teach you proper eating etiquette. That's the right word, you know? And one of the things that they taught me is smacking. Smacking is not like, it's not appropriate when you're eating like at a table full of people. Like, imagine you just eating there and somebody just constantly fucking smacking that shit, bro. Like, you know what I mean? But they told me not to smack. They told me about the fucking forks and spoons and all that bullshit. You know what I mean? And from that day on, the bullshit thing that I remember is about smacking. From that day on, I never like smacked again, bro. Especially not intentional. I would do it unintentionally if I forget to like not do it, but I try to make it a habit not to fucking smack that shit. You feel me? But yeah, bro. Let's try the food and shit. Hold on. Another thing that these ladies, they taught me was, I remember this shit vividly because it was on the table and they would show me. It was like, whenever you're eating with whenever you're eating around people and you want to talk, always cover your mouth. Like, cover your mouth so that people don't have to see you fucking chewing and not eating with your fucking mouth open and shit. They taught me that shit, you know? They taught me to be a closed mouth chewer. You know what I mean? Like, bro, who the fuck? Like, imagine you're sitting at a table full of people and like there's a nigga in one of the seats. Nigga's chewing with his fucking mouth open. He's talking. And his food is falling out of his mouth and shit. Like, ugh. You know what I mean? Like, why the fuck would you want to eat around that bitch ass nigga? You feel me? But she was like, yeah, whenever you eat around people or whenever you just eat in general, always close your mouth when you're chewing. Don't chew with your fucking mouth open and shit, you know? Close your mouth. And then if you want to talk, cover your mouth, you know? So that, like, people don't have to fucking see you chewing and shit. That shit is disgusting. That's another thing that they taught me and shit. The ladies in Georgia, you know? I still remember all these lessons and shit from this was like 14, 15 years ago, bro, you know? Holy shit, bro. Hold on. I'm not gonna lie. I think this food is helping clear out my throat, bro. Because now I can swallow, but it's still a little bit hard. But now I can swallow at least. Holy shit. Hold on, bro. Get over here, bitch. Another lesson this beautiful lady taught me is like, we all know about the whole, well, I don't know if all of you guys know, but they told me about this shit, putting the napkin here and putting it, when you're wearing a suit or you're wearing some trousers, put the napkin on your lap. So when the food falls, they fall on the napkin and not your clothes. And then put in one here so the food falls, it goes on the napkin, not your clothes. But another thing they taught me was always wiping my mouth, especially when I eat food that's oily. Cause then my mouth is gonna be all oily and shit, and it's gonna be all dirty because it's gonna have all the like the food components and all that shit, for lack of better words. So always wiping my mouth and shit when you're eating, so that you don't have like a dirty appearance to the face, you know. Another thing the ladies taught me back in the day. But like it's getting easier for me to swallow now, bro. I'm not gonna lie, bro. This shit is working like a miracle drug. Holy shit. Oh, you know another thing that I hate is when you're eating with somebody, right? Like, let's say you're eating with your sister, or you're eating with your best friend, or you're eating with a stranger. Just anybody. It could be even your mom or your dad. And you're eating with them. I hate when people that you're eating with, especially if you guys share the same plate, and they come, they grab some food, and they go over the plate like this. And they eat over the plate of food that you guys are both sharing. I hate that shit, bro. Because what the fuck, bitch? I don't want to touch your mouth. You know what I mean? Even with my girl. Like, we want to share a plate, nigga. The fuck, bitch? Take the food and go out. Use your, that's another thing they just told me. Use your hand. You know what I mean? As a folding table of some sorts. Like, nigga, the fuck? Don't go over the food and start eating and shit, especially when you're sharing with somebody. Well, now, if you're eating alone, that's understandable because you don't want to make a mess on the table. But if you're sharing with somebody, nigga, take that shit, take it away from the plate and eat. The fuck? Don't fucking put it over my plate and start going to town. No, nigga, the fuck? Because we're both sharing this food. And I'm not trying to taste the inside of your mouth, bitch. The fuck? You dirty whore, you know? So, that's one, you know, one of my other pet peeves. It's like, bro, like, nigga, take that shit, nigga, put it, you know what I mean? And enjoy the food, bro, and then come back. And then go out, come back, go out, come back, go out. Nigga, the fuck? Don't stay here and eat that motherfucker like you're eating some ass. Hell no. And look, I'm spitting like a motherfucker. That's why you're supposed to cover your mouth. So even if you were to spit, it will fall into your hands like this. You see that shit? And it wouldn't fucking fling everywhere and fly everywhere. You feel me? I just made my way back to Walmart, and I'm not gonna lie, bro. My whole body feels lazy than a bitch, bro. I don't feel like doing anything, bro. I feel sluggish. I feel lazy as fuck, bro. So I'm gonna see if they have like some pill. I'm not gonna lie, bro. She bad as fuck. Shit. How you doing? But I'm gonna see if they have like some pills and shit that I can take. Cause fuck, nigga, I feel lazy than them. You know? But yeah, bro. So I just made my way here. Then I'm gonna go back to the church and shit and see what they talk about over there. You know what? It's actually a good thing that I came out here because I need to pick up some of this shit. I need to pick some of this stuff out. Like, these are like travel size, body wash, deodorant, all that shit. I'm gonna pick some of these bitches up right now. Let's see. I'm gonna show you. Is this Benadryl? No. What does that say? Pep 2? Pep 2? Bismol. Pep 2 Bismol. What the fuck is that, bro? Nasal, heartburn, indigestion, upset stomach, diarrhea. Shit. This is clutch. I'm gonna take one of these. Body lotion, hell yeah. I'm gonna take one of these bitches. God damn. I'm gonna take one of these bitches too. One of these little Hold on, let me go get a cart. Let me go get a cart real quick. Bro, I told y'all niggas I was feeling lazy than a bitch. I'm telling you, bro. We'll get one of these bitches. Get one of these. So this is the food I just ended up picking up right here. You know? Well, if we were to be honest, bro, I'm a fucking whore for bananas. I love bananas, boy. Look, should I get more? Nah, I think this should be good for now. So far, and it's almost $20, bro, for a couple things and some bananas and shit. You think I'll make this shit? Look, hold on, let me see. I think I'll make it. Let me see. God damn it, fuck. I don't have it like I used to. Nigga, fuck that shit. But look, I'm about to go see what kind of beverages they got in this motherfucker. But this is the first time I've ever seen one of these gas stations. It's drips. Bro, don't tell me the fucking D'Amelio family is the one that started this shit. Be happy snacks. What the fuck? So you're telling me these motherfuckers started this? What the fuck? So we just came back from what? Hell yeah. Just came from Burlington, and I better go back to the church and shit and see what the fuck they got, what they talking about, you know. But I'm gonna show you guys what I got later from Burlington and shit. I'm not gonna lie, bro. I'm lucky about to go in there and sleep like a motherfucker in the church. Cause they love talking, bro. So I'm probably gonna go in there and sleep like a bitch.
There's another one?
Dude, that shit is deep as hell.
You're deep as hell. Bro.
The swimming club, you guys never been there?
Bro. All this stuff I got from Walmart and Burlington. This is all from Walmart and shit. I got sleep aid. I got allergy relief, deodorant, travel, toothbrush, not toothbrush, toothpaste, more toothpaste, first aid kit, body wash, and shampoo. Oh, fuck, I got the wrong one. I don't use shampoo or conditioner. Fuck. Then some tissues and a toothbrush. And then this one I got from Burlington. I got these shorts for fucking, no. I got them for $10, like right there. And then I got these socks. These bitches are for $10. Look at this shit, bro. Nigga Claude brought me some socks and they had a fucking, you see that shit? That shit is crazy. Right when I got these bitches. Feel me? Oh, and then I also got some bananas from Walmart and shit. I'm a whore for bananas, like I said, bro. But I'm trying to see if I can, like, take a little nap, bro, because I'm not gonna lie, I'm tired as fuck. I'm gonna see if I can take a little nap, bro. See if I can, like, get rejuvenated, and have some energy and shit, cause I'm about to see it, bro. I'm exhausted. Yeah. I'm gonna talk to y'all niggas later, bro. I'm out this bitch, bro.
Yo,
Yo, what's up, bro? Fuck, nigga. God damn, boy. God damn, boy. Oh, shit. Oh, shit, boy. Nigga, tell you what, boy. Oh. Bro, I literally just woke up right now, bro. Literally this. Remember I told y'all niggas I was gonna sleep, bro? I literally just woke up like 3 minutes ago. I think it's raining, hold on, let me see. Oh, dude, it's raining like a motherfucker. Oh, dude, this is so beautiful. What I'm gonna show you. But it's raining like a motherfucker. I don't know if you can see that shit. Nigga. Yeah. Yeah, bro. I'm about to go wash my face. Then I'm gonna have somebody come pick me up right now. I wanna go back to the church and shit. Excuse me, bro, do I have a lazy eye, bro? Look at my face, tell me if I have a lazy eye or not, bro. Cause this girl, she just told me that I had a what's up, man? She just told me that I had like a lazy eye. Yeah. Shit. Oh, ass nigga. The fuck? That nigga weird. Nigga just came out the house and didn't say nothing. Shit. But yeah, bro. My throat still hurt, bro. I took these fucking. I went to Walmart and I bought these bitches. Remember I showed you earlier. I took these bitches, bro. I was knocked the fuck out, bro. I'm not gonna lie to you, gang. Oh. And I just woke up right now because of that. So, I'm about to see if I can get something to eat, bro. I'm hungry than a bitch, boy. But yeah, bro. That's the update. Shit. We made our way to fucking Ross and shit.
Two is a horse. Do you hear that clock?
Hey, give me the key. Huh? Give me the key.
You better go see the car?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. Okay. I'm gonna. I'm gonna keep them. I'm gonna keep. I'm gonna hostile them.
Alright. They're out here trying to buy some shit for dinner. My sister and her friend. Shorty bad as fuck. The thing with shopping with women is the fact that like they be taking forever, bro. This is with my sister and shit, bro. Like when I take them to the store, or take them out to the store or whatever, bro. Even my mom and my grandma, they be in there for hours, bro. That shit's so annoying. You know what I mean? Like they don't know. They don't know what they want. And then they be looking around and shit. Like a nigga got all day, you know? Fuck. But I'ma just chill in the car while they shop and shit. And then whenever they get ready to go. Ugh. We'll head out and shit. You feel me? Shit, we're coming to Texas Roadhouse to eat some fucking dinner and shit. You know, I'm gonna show y'all niggas what I get. I just came from the dinner and shit. I'm not gonna lie, bro, it's cold as fuck in there, bro. God damn. Fuck. Arizona has fucked me up, bro. But every time I come to Texas Roadhouse, I always get the same shit, which is the kids mini cheeseburger meal, bro. You feel me? I don't like spending money on, like, well, I do, but I do and I don't like spending money on food, because like once you digest that shit, it goes in your system. That's it, you know. Fuck, I sound like an old ass nigga, you know. But I don't really like spending money on food and shit, to be honest with you. And so every time I go to the cheeseburger or the fucking Texas Roadhouse, I always get the same shit. You feel me? But I think now we're gonna go home, chill for a little bit, and I think we'll do some other shit, but I don't know yet. And then, yes, tomorrow, I was hoping we could go to, like, the spot that they were showing me. No, the door's over there.
The entrance?
Yeah. It's almost like a resort. And go swimming and shit, but who knows. The problem that I have with vlogging and shit is, nigga, my hand be tired than a bitch, bro, just from holding this camera and shit, bro. Fuck. I gotta find a solution to this shit, cause I can't do it for that long, bro. My hand be hurting like a bitch, bro. I'm gonna keep it a beam with you. But yeah, man. Look, bro, this is about to be random as hell, but I'm just standing here waiting for these niggas to come out and shit. And I just got to thinking about how, like, this is really random, but like on this trip, it just shows me how grateful I am for my parents, bro. I'm so grateful for having my mom, my dad, my grandma, all of them in my life, especially my dad, bro. Cause I know there's a lot of people that don't have parents, don't have both parents in their life right now, bro. And it's a huge disadvantage to them, because there's a lot that they get to miss out on, bro. Like, just this whole trip alone just showed me how grateful I really am for my parents, especially my dad, bro. How grateful I am for the things that he do for me, the things that he does for all of us as a family, as a collective, you know? Like, I'm grateful that, like, he's been in my life to where I am now, because now I have a sense of direction on what to do and where to go, you know? Because I was able to look at his footprint, and I wouldn't necessarily compare, but I can look at what he has achieved and think to myself, you know what, I can do that as well, you know? And I'm grateful because he has instilled that in me, and without him being a part of my life, or without him being in my life, like, I don't think I would have any idea on what I should do about life, bro, you know? Because of my dad, bro, I want to have a lot of kids, bro. I want to get married to a good, submissive African queen that's going to ride by my side for the rest of my days, you know? But this is really random, but shit, bro, I was just thinking, like, man, I'm so grateful, bro. And I know a lot of niggas is jealous than a motherfucker, bro, because I have both parents and they don't. You feel me? Close as shit is. There's a little gas station. That's our hotel right there. The gas station is literally right here. It's called All Subs, and then our telly's right there. This is the convention center we're gonna be at. Shit's nice as fuck.
Yeah.
To conclude our trip, we are about to start heading back to Arizona, but we're stopping at Flying J gas station. We're gonna fill up on the fuel, get some drinks and shit, use the bathroom, and then we're gonna hit the road for 12 hours heading back to AZ. I've been looking kind of bad, I'm not gonna lie, bro. Shit. Yeah, bro, Texas was a vibe. I'm not gonna lie. But I'm gonna talk to y'all niggas later. We are right at the halfway point in our trip. I just drove the last like 5.5 hours. So now my dad's about to take over and drive the next 4 hours. And then that ain't a car is going to, drive the rest of the way to a crib and shit. But yeah, this is just a little update and shit, you know what I mean? But we're going to be home in about eight and a half hours type shit, you know what I mean? Bro, I just made it back to the suburbs. I just got done with the fucking 14-hour drive back to Arizona. I'm back in my mansion. Oh, my comfortable ass. Oh, bed. Oh. Oh. Fuck. I'm about to turn the fucking... Remember I showed you this shit? How my bed is heated? Well, my blanket. And I had that weighted blanket. Nigga, I'm gonna sleep good as fuck. Oh. And I don't gotta go to work until like later on today. So I'm about to knock the fuck out, bro. But I'm gonna talk to y'all niggas another day, bro. But also remember, bro, this is our time together, bro. Unfortunately, I didn't have time to watch any of my videos because I literally just got here right now, and we still gotta unpack our stuff and shit. But I'm about to knock the fuck out, bro. I'm tired of the bitch. Well, cause I was driving so it was a 12-hour drive. I drove like 9 hours, and then everybody else, my dad drove, and you know how it goes. So I'm about to crash out, bro. But it was an African conference. It was a church conference. That's why we went to Abilene. My family was invited. Well, my family in the church was invited to go out there for the conference. So we went and we had a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun. I got to see I could go on and on, but I'm just going to cut it here and say I had an amazing time. I would do it again. 10 out of 10 would recommend. If you've never been to Abilene, go check it out. It's a small little town. It's about yay. In terms of size and population, so it's pretty small. Not a lot to do, but the people are cool and friendly. The service was good, but let me stop yapping, bro, because I'm tired. My hand is shaking like a bitch, because nigga, this camera is heavier than a motherfucker. So I'm gonna see y'all niggas next time, and sayonara.